average of 30 container ships has sat anchored daily just off the coast of Los Angeles this year.
The normal number of container ships at anchor is 0 to 1.
This ship, the Everfront, not to be confused with the now famous Ever Given, was waiting for 13 days.
Seeing vessels at anchorage outside the nation's largest container port does not happen every day. And it is a once in about a decade situation that we see.
Everfront was part of a bottleneck in the supply chain that's still straining the neighboring ports, which handle about a third of all U.S. imports.
I don't think it's an exaggeration to say that the ports have never really seen this confluence of stresses that they've had to deal with.
So what's causing this offshore queue? How do these waiting ships impact customers onshore? And when will it return to normal?
I think we got here because we all had to stay home.
Experts say if there's one cause for the backup, it's COVID-19.
Staying home leads you to go, all right, my desk isn't great if I've got one. My chair isn't comfortable even if I've got one. I might need a new computer monitor. I might need a webcam. Actually, I can't go to the gym, so I'm going to go buy a Peloton or a running machine or some dumbbells.
For many Americans, that has meant placing online orders for those items, most of which aren't made in the U.S. Seaborne imports to the U.S. started surging in the late summer as manufacturers and retailers tried to rebuild inventories that were depleted by shoppers in the early months of the pandemic.
We had 57 extra ships arrive in the fall above normal levels, which choked the system because at that same time, the goods movement system ashore, the terminals, the trains, the trucks, the warehouses, the forklift drivers, had some fraction of the workforce out with COVID and a different fraction out because of contact tracing. So just when there's more cargo, there's a less efficient goods movement system ashore, so the ships backed up.
But shipments continued, peaking in February when 177 container ships carrying more than 800,000 containers arrived at the Southern California ports. That's 31% more ships and 49% more containers than the same month last year. This gap highlights a related issue. The ships are getting bigger.
There's been a significant increase in the number of the very biggest boats that come in. And whilst they're very efficient when they're at sea, they're a devil to unpack and a devil to park. And so it takes longer to get all of them sorted out.
So the ships continue to wait an average of 7.5 days before reaching the port. And that means consumers are waiting too.
Okay, Peloton, let's go.
This is something buyers of Peloton bikes may already know. The company said in its latest earnings report that backups contributed to recent shipping delays.
I'm sure you've seen that on a lot of e-commerce sites. It's taking longer than normal to deliver to you. And so, you know, there's that kind of customer disappointment angle, and companies will then need to think, okay, how do I avoid that in the future?
Peloton, come on, let's get this workout started.
For Peloton, the answer has been to spend more. The company said it would spend $100 million in transportation, including air shipments, in the first half of the year to get around the bottlenecks at the port. Mom-and-pop retailers also have products they'd hope to sell stuck on these ships, and many of the smallest shops can't afford to fly products in instead. But the ships aren't the only issue here. The entire supply chain, from ports to warehouses to distribution centers, is inundated with cargo.
So if the cargo is not moving quickly from the ship to the shore, out through the warehouses to the consumer, everything else is going to start to back up.
This congestion, which was driven by demand for shipping, also means that the cost of shipping has gone up. The current global average shipping rate is nearly 4 times what it was in January 2020, according to data from S&P Global Platts.
Someone's going to pay for that. It's either going to come off companies' profits or they're going to pass it through to consumers. The longer it lasts, the more likely it is that consumers are going to pay it.
At the ports, workers are pushing to get the anchored ships moving.
Pre-pandemic, we were welcoming, on average, 10 container vessels in to work at the port, loading and unloading containers every day. During this surge, we've been averaging 15 vessels working every day in the port. That's a 50% jump in productivity alongside our vessels every day.
Soroka says the port's short-term strategy focuses on vaccinating workers, maximizing efficiencies, and asking importers to more quickly pick up cargo. That, he predicts, will help clear the backlog of ships by this summer. any longer could bring more problems.
We have a short window here before our traditional peak season kicks off in August for back to school, other retail requirements, and the all-important year-end holiday.
With Americans receiving a fresh round of stimulus, this bottleneck could intensify. And how states and the federal government proceed with reopening may impact that.
If we're going to spend another summer lockdown, then people are going to be buying, you know, new lawn chairs and a whole bunch of stuff they didn't buy last year. If everything's open again and people can go on vacation, it's all services spending. We're not going to buy stuff. So the demand for shipping will drop off relatively quickly.